J-Ray 501. I am in the Orange County Register OC Watchdog. Edison employees rack up millions in business expenses. Really not surprised. The highest paid 10% of Southern California Edison employees earned at least $418.8 million in combined total compensation during 2011 and charged at least $11.8 million to their expense accounts, according to a report the public utility filed with the state. SCE's most recent annual report showed 19 executives and other SCE employees received more than $1 million in total compensation during 2011, and at least 130 others received $300,000 or more in total compensation. The 2,094 employees who earned at least $125,000 in base salary racked up a combined $10.5 million in business expenses. Four of the employees charged more than $100,000 to their business expense accounts, with the top spender identified only as Manager 3, charging $192,402, according to the report. The median expense total for those 2,094 employees was $3,358. Staggering numbers. What specific items employees and executives charge to their accounts is anyone's guess, at least right now, because SCE declined to provide documentation or details of spending. Instead, SCE officials provided general comments in a written statement. Sometimes, employee-related business expenses are incurred and charged to credit cards for a group of individuals or a department, including the expenses charged by the individuals who have been identified, the statement said. These charges are reported under the employee responsible for the company-issued credit card. Charges are recorded to either ratepayer or shareholder accounts based on the business activity for which is incurred. SCE officials did not say which expenses charged by individual employees reflected business expenses for other employees, nor did they say which expenses or what percentage of the expenses were charged to shareholder accounts. Ratepayer advocates said the report suggests that some SCE employees may be living the high life at ratepayers' expense. No. Really? Oh, that's terrible. Overall, when you look at this, you have the sense of a company that is living high on the hog, said Mindy Spatt, spokeswoman for nonprofit ratepayer advocate group, the Utility Reform Network, or TURN. Their executives have huge salaries and huge expense accounts. The majority of the money these highly paid executives are getting comes right out of ratepayers' pockets. Imagine that. Most of their expenses are billed to ratepayers, too. Isn't that double dipping? Wow. Wow. I didn't even feel like I got fucked. What a bummer. I at least like to feel it. SCE ratepayers covered most or all of the employees' compensation and expenses, according to documents the utility filed with the state, and ratepayers kicked in part of the total compensation for a handful of executives shared by SCE and related companies, including the top official at SCE's parent company, Edison International, who earned $10.8 million in 2011 and charged $372,000 to his expense account. Peter Thomas Dietrich, SVP and Chief Nuclear Officer responsible for overseeing SCE's nuclear business at the San Onofre Nuclear Generating Station, earned $1,291,869 in total compensation in 2011. That's according to the report. His total compensation included a performance-based annual bonus of close to $300,000. And not included in Dietrich's total compensation was a $350,000 hiring bonus, $75,000 housing stipend, a moving and mileage expense payment of $342,000+, and $89,000+ in charges to his expense account, the report said. With total compensation, that all adds up to about $2 million, and that's not including the business expenses. Dietrich replaced Ross Ridenour, who left his post for the good of the station after allegations of deep distrust between some employees and management at the plant surfaced in 2010. Ridenour received a cash severance payment of $581,000+ upon his departure, as well as a $31,000 in relocation expenses, according to SCE's 2010 compensation report. Neither figure was included in his total compensation, which could not be determined based on the figures listed in the report because his name was redacted. Oh my. Little cover up there. Two unnamed employees with the SVP and Chief Nuclear Officer title were listed as employees who retired, or they were fired, or they died, or they were taking a leave of absence in 2010. We don't know. But according to the 2010 compensation report, the employees received total compensation of $283,824 and $2,557,014, respectively. The numbers appear in reports SCE and other California utility companies must file annually with the California Public Utilities Commission, or CPUC. The reports, which show total compensation and business expenses for executives and employees who earned more than $125,000 in base salary during the year the report covers, provide transparency and information for officials to consider when deciding whether a rate increase is justified. Oh. Well, I'm sure it's justified. The CPUC does not collect or routinely audit business expenses, but ratepayer advocacy groups sometimes request the information and perform audits when utilities apply for state's permission to raise rates. It did not appear that any groups audited business expenses when SCE applied for a rate increase starting in 2012. Spat said the advocacy group's audits include checks to make sure shareholders are covering lobbying expenses and other costs that cannot be billed to ratepayers. Okay, I think we've had just about enough numbers, or at least I have. I'll leave the link and you can come in here and further boggle your mind with all of these silly numbers. This really is nothing new. This is pretty much the benchmark for how things are done in the nuclear industry. Now you know why they refuse to give it up. Okay, SCE, Southern California Edison, serves 4.9 million customers in a 50,000 square mile service area within Central, Coastal, and Southern California, including much of Orange County. Southern California's Edison forecasted revenue requirement, the money the company need to bring in order to operate, was $6.3 billion, according to SCE's most recent application for a rate increase. The company expected to employ over 18,000 workers in 2012, the majority of the employees' wages and benefits, about 80%, were funded with money from ratepayers. I think it's ratepayers. That's it. Ratepayers. Okay. So, you would think that they would know that they're under the microscope. But you know what? This is just a blatant, in-your-face, we don't care, business as usual. You can't touch us, na-na-na-na-na-na. So, the only thing left is to say a prayer that Senator Boxer is the only voice that is going to make any sense out of trying to keep songs closed down, San Onofre nuclear generating station. All right. Danger, high radiation due to greed, Southern California Edison. As always, God bless.